Hello and welcome. In this video, we are discussing different age detection technique based on first derivative. In the part 1 of this age detection, we have discussed how to obtain the first derivative. First derivative at any pixel in an image is obtained by magnitude of gradient at that pixel. And the gradient is approximated by standard finite difference approximation for the first partial derivative in x and y direction. Let us take a small review of the previous session so that we can continue with the different methods. This is the candidate pixel where we want to take a gradient. So gradient is magnitude. Magnitude of gradient is gradient in x direction, gradient in y direction square, and under root of that. This is nothing but the magnitude of gradient, and this we can consider as a first derivative. So these are the x direction. We are taking the first difference, the next pixel in x direction minus the present pixel, that is z8 minus z5. Similarly in y direction, next pixel minus the present pixel, z6 minus z5. So we are taking the mod, and as it is a mod, we can exchange the position. It doesn't matter, z5 minus z8, z5 minus z6. And from that, we are obtaining the mask z5 1, and its coefficient, z8 coefficient is minus 1. z5, z8, 1 minus 1, and 1 minus 1. Like this, this is the first derivative we are obtaining. And then one more we discussed in the last video is, this is the ramp-like structure of an edge in an image, and its first derivative is like this. At different pixel, we are calculating the magnitude of the gradient. And to decide the edge pixel, we are deciding the threshold. Suppose this is the threshold. So whatever the pixel which lies between this range A to B are considered as a edge pixels. So this whole range is considered as a edge pixels in a first derivative. So first method in this first derivative is the Robert mask. If you observe this mask which we developed here, this is the 1 minus 1 and 1 minus 1, x directional mask and y directional mask. Robert in his paper stated that better result can be obtained if cross differences were taken. So for x directional mass, instead of taking the vertical difference, cross references will give the better result. Similarly for y direction, cross references will give the better result. You can refer this figure. Instead of taking the vertical difference, cross references will give the better result. So the formula will be z5 minus z9, and here z6 minus z8. So to calculate a gradient, this cross differences will give the better result according to the Robert. Next operators are Prewitt and Sobel operator. Prewitt in his paper in 1970 proposed that first derivative is approximated by assigning a similar weight to all the neighbors of candidate pixel whose edge strength we are calculating. And Sobel also, same, he has considered the neighbors, only the difference is in Sobel operator, higher weights are assigned to the pixel close to the candidate pixel. So this is our candidate pixel, and according to the Sobel and Prewitt, all the neighbors we are considering. In Prewitt, we are assigning similar weights to the all the neighbors, and in Sobel, we are assigning higher weights to the pixels which are close to the candidate pixel. So these pixels are close to the candidate pixel, and these diagonal pixels are little bit far away as compared to these pixels. So let us see, this is our candidate pixel, Prewitt operator. In x directional mass, to detect the edges, x directional means we are taking the gradient in x direction, and always edges detected will be perpendicular to the gradient direction. So if the gradient is in x direction, we will detect the vertical edges, and if gradient is y directional, we will detect the edges in a horizontal direction. Always it is perpendicular to the direction of gradient. and this is the mass for a y-directional gradient. We can represent mathematically the coefficient of z7, z8, z9 as 1 and z1, z2, z3 coefficients are minus 1. So z7, z8, z9 minus z1, z2, z3 x directional, and we can combine the y directional plus this one is z3, z6, z9 minus z1, z4, z7. So this is the mathematical representation to calculate the gradient according to the Privet operator. Sobel operator. In Sobel operator, same as the Privet, only higher weights are assigned to the pixel which are close to the candidate pixel. So for x directional, these pixels are close to the candidate pixel. So we are assigning the higher weights to these pixels. So we are assigning higher weights to the pixels which are close to the candidate pixel. This is the mass for the gradient in x directional. This is the mass for the gradient in y directional. We are assigning higher weights to the pixels which are close to the candidate pixel. We can represent this mathematically. Z7 twice z8 plus z9 minus z1 minus twice z2 minus z3. Similarly, in y directional, z3 twice z6 z9 minus z1 twice z4 minus z7. So this is the mathematical representation for the gradient for the Sobel operator. This is the example which I have mentioned here. Just you will get the idea when you are convolving the image with the mask of x gradient and with the mask of y gradient, what will be the result. Only the difference is Robert, Privet, Sobel, you will get the different quality of edges. So this is the original image. This is the x gradient. I have taken here Sobel operator, x gradient mass. So the edges detected and the gradient direction is perpendicular. So this is the x directional gradient and the edges detected are vertical. For y directional gradient, edges detected are horizontal. So whatever the vertical edges in this image will be get detected by x gradient mass, and whatever the horizontal edges in the image will get by y directional gradient. And if we'll add these two images, you will get the combined result. This is not a natural image. I have created this image on a computer. Now, one more thing here. Instead of adding the result of x directional gradient and y directional gradient to get the combined result, we can add the mask. So, Privet operator, this is x directional gradient, y directional gradient, we can add this mass to get the combined result. Similarly, for Sobel operator, we can add this. So instead of convolving image separately with the x gradient and y directional gradient and then add, we can convolve the image with this combined mass to get the both horizontal and vertical edges in the image. Similarly, with the Sobel operator, we can directly convolve the image with this mass to get both the directional edges. Now, Sobel and Privet filter or operator has an advantage. It provides smoothing along with the differentiation. Smoothing operation is nothing but low pass filtering, and differentiation operation is nothing but high pass filtering. It provides the smoothing in one directional with the edge detection in perpendicular direction. Let us see, this is the x directional mass of Privet and this one is y directional mass of Privet. This first column, minus 1, 0, 1. The summation of the coefficient is 0, means it is high pass filtering. And this last row, 1, 1, 1, means it is low pass filtering, averaging filtering. So smoothing is done in one direction and edge detection, that is high pass filtering, is done in perpendicular direction of this smoothing. Here also same, averaging is done in one directional and smoothing is done in another direction, perpendicular direction. So this is the advantage of Prebit, and in Sobel also you will find the same. Only there is a higher weight to the pixels which are close to the candidate pixel. So why this is an advantage, that smoothing in one direction and edge detection in another direction is an advantage of Prebit and Sobel filtering. If you observe all the mass, Sobel mass, Prebit mass, then Robert mass, the summation of coefficient is zero. Means all are the high pass filtering mass. As edge in the image is the high frequency component, to detect the edge, we need to use high pass filtering mask. But as we all know, the noise in the image is also high frequency component. So when we are detecting the edges with these masks, noise also get enhanced. That's why if we blur the noise, smooth the noise and detect the edges, it will give the better result for the edge detection. That's why this Prebit and Sobel has an advantage that it will smooth the noise, along with that in perpendicular direction it will detect the edges also. Compass operator. If you observe the previous gradient mass like Robert mass, then Prebit mass, Sobel mass, all these mass we have defined for x directional gradient and y directional gradient, and with this you can detect only the edges in x directional and y directional, that is the horizontal and vertical edges can be detected with this mass. To detect the edges in all direction, we can rotate the Prebit and Sobel mass in all direction in anti-clockwise. Let us see. We'll take just example of one mass. This is the x directional Prebit mass. It is x directional means it will detect the edge in a perpendicular direction. That means it will detect all the vertical edges. Now detect the edges in all direction. We'll rotate this mass in anti-clockwise direction. So here we rotated by one pixel only. This pixel will come here. This pixel will come here. This pixel will come here. We rotated it by just one pixel. Then next, again we will rotate by one pixel, means this pixel will come here, this will come here, this will come here. Again we will rotate. Like this we will get different nine mass by rotation one by one by one pixel. And if we will control the image with all this mass, we will get the edges in all direction. We need to add the result of all this convolution. You will get the edges in the image in all direction. So in this video, we discuss Robert mass, Prebit mass and Sobel mass. Robert mass, it is a 2x2 mass, and it shows that the cross differences will give better result than the vertical and horizontal differences. Then Prebit and Sobel, instead of using 2x2 mass, 3x3 mass gives the better result. And one more thing in Prebit and Sobel is that it performs the smoothing operation along with the edge detection. All are the first derivative mass. Thank you.